Hello, welcome back to my channel, Cassie's Gaming. Today I'm playing Red Dead Redemption 2, and please subscribe and let's play.
Hey, Arthur!
What do you want?
Uncle told me something about a train.
What did he say?
Mary Beth overheard something about a train full of wealthy folk rolling down through Scarlet Meadows just south of the state border.
Yes.
You need help with it?
I ain't even sure about doing it.
Come on. At night, not too guarded, it's perfect.
Nah, I ain't thought it through. Stopping a train, pain in the ass.
Sure, but what if we could force a train to stop?
Well, of course.
We get a wagon full of something flammable, oil. Put it on the tracks. They see it. They know they either have to stop or die. Ain't no train driver wants to be cooked alive.
That is kind of brilliant. For you. That is a real idea. I think that's the first time you ever had one of them.
Shut up.
You might be the first bastard to ever have half his brains eaten by a wolf and end up more intelligent.
So we're doing it?
Yeah, we're gonna need ammunition, guns, look real frightening, and some dynamite to open up the train.
I'll get the supplies. Gotta head into town for Abigail anyway. Don't even ask. You go find us an oil wagon.
Yeah, I know just the place. They're always heading into that refinery.
There's an old rundown shack just over the border, north of a place called Dewberry Creek. Leave it hidden somewhere near there.
Morning, Arthur.
Let's go, boy.
Good morning, Arthur.
Thank you.
I ain't finished.
This is a warning.
Sorry. No, I'll stop it now.
On my way.
Keep moving.
Yep.
Get. He's just a younger version of you.
Please don't say that to me, Dutch.
Oh, it's true. It's true.
John?
Let's get on.
Good. And you?
Got everything we need.
Good. I think we need another man. Charles?
I'll go get him. Meet us at the wagon when you can.
Sure.
See you, Arthur. Ain't that dumb.
Next time, let the wolves eat all your brain. Then you'll be a genius.
All good? Have a seat.
Hey, Arthur. Come here a minute.
What is it?
Can I ask you a favor?
Probably not.
Very funny. Would you do something with Jack? He seems kind of down. All this upheaval can't have been easy on the poor kid.
Why? Because I'm your preferred nursemaid?
Because he likes you and, well, you know his father's useless.
Okay.
Thank you.
What you up to?
Playing.
Anything fun?
I guess.
You want to come fishing with me?
Fishing?
Sure. You're... It's about time that you started earning your cape.
Okay.
Good. Let's go get your pole then. Now, you do have a fishing pole, don't you?
I sure do. Uncle Jose made me one.
Good. Well, let's go get it then. Go catch us some fish.
Yeah.
I'll mount up and lift you on when you're ready. All right. Let's go then.
So, where are we going?
Just down to the river near here. We shouldn't go too far from camp.
Oh, okay.
Feeling better? I know you was a little sick.
Oh, I'm fine.
You're a brave kid.
So, just like you.
Well, I don't know about brave. I ain't much of a kid no more. Well, your mama might disagree. Her and a few other women, I guess.
What do you mean?
I'm just talking silly. It's been a tough few weeks up in that snow.
I like the snow.
Yes, but not like that.
When are we going back to the other camp?
The one near Blackwater?
Yeah.
Well, we're not. This is our spot. For now, anyway. Why?
I forgot a storybook there. We left so quick.
All right. This looks as good a spot as any.
Where should we stand, Uncle Arthur?
Down by the shore. Come on, follow me. Now first, we need some bait. I'm gonna use some cheese.
Cheese?
Smellier the better. Now, cast your line. Swing the rod back over your shoulder. And bring it forward in a smooth motion. Use your wrist, not your elbow.
Like that?
That's it. Good. All we do now, Jack, is wait for a fish to take the bait.
How do I know when I've got a bite?
Well, if you feel the tip of your fishing rod just twitching, don't yank it yet. That just means one's nibbling. If you feel a hard tug, that's a fish going for the bait, so yank hard to hook it.
Something's tugging at your rod, Uncle Arthur.
Got one, Jack.
Pull him in!
You see him fighting there, Jack? That's when you gotta be careful. You'll break the line. Best to wear him out first before you try to reel him in. Now, seems like he's taking a rest now. I'm gonna try reeling him in nice and steady.
This is a great fishing spot.
Don't jinx it, kid. You okay there?
I think so. This is hard. Why am I not catching any?
Just be patient.
My arms are tired.
You're all right. You know, this reminds me. I taught another boy to fish once, long time ago.
Do you mean Lenny?
No. No, this was long before I met Lenny. Long before you was even born. Look, Jack, it's a bluegill. It's almost as small as you. We should really throw these smaller ones back. Give them a chance to grow up a bit.
Can I take a break from fishing? I want to make something.
Okay.
I'm gonna pick some of those red flowers. I'll be right back.
Whoop, think I got one. You gotta stick at things, Jack. Well, this is clearly the spot for bluegill.
Joey's boring, Uncle Arthur.
I know. Boring as hell. But then, something happens. And you can get food for days.
Really?
If you're lucky. Then you just sit, wait, try not to worry. It's good for you.
It's good for you?
I guess.
Huh. Hey, look at this.
And what?
This necklace I made.
Necklace?
For Mama.
Sure.
What a fine young man. And in such complex circumstances. Arthur, isn't it? Arthur Morgan?
Who are you?
Yes, Arthur Morgan, Vanderlyn's most trusted associate. You've read the files. Typical case, orphaned street kid seduced by that maniac's silver tongue and matures into a degenerate murderer. Agent Milton, Agent Ross, Pinkerton Detective Agency, seconded to the United States government. Nice to finally meet. We know a lot about you.
Do you?
You're a wanted man, Mr. Morgan. There's $5,000 for your head alone.
$5,000? For me? Can I turn myself in?
We want Vanderlyn.
Old Dutch. I haven't seen him for months.
That's so. Because I heard a guy fitting his description robbed a train belonging to Leviticus Cornwall up near Granite Pass.
Oh, ain't that a little old-fashioned nowadays?
Apparently not. Listen. This is my offer, Mr. Morgan. Bring in Vanderlyn, and you have my word you won't swing.
Oh, I ain't gonna swing anyways, Agent.
Milton.
You see, I haven't done anything wrong, aside from not playing the games to your rules.
Spare me the philosophy lesson. I've already heard it. From Mac Callender.
Mac Callender?
He was pretty shot up by the time I got to him. So really, it was more of a mercy killing. Slow, but merciful.
You enjoy being a rich man's toy, dear?
I enjoy society, flaws and all. You people venerate savagery, and you will die. Savagely. All of you.
Oh, we're all gonna die, Agent.
Some of us sooner than others. Good day, Mr. Morgan.
Goodbye.
Enjoy your fishing, kid. while you still can.
Who are they?
No one to worry about, no one at all. Come on, let's pick up your things and get home.
It's getting late, Jack. Your mother will be worried. Let's head back. Giddy up. Disagreeable man, and I don't want them to hurt him.
What did they mean about Matt? Is he in jail?
No, I don't think so. I hope he's just fine where he is. Like I said, don't worry about them. The world is full of disagreeable men. That's why you got all of us protective folk like them. Now, how about that necklace you made? You still got it, right?
Yeah, I got it.
Good. Did you like fishing?
It was okay, I think. It's a lot of waiting around.
It is.
Great! We caught a fish, and I made you this necklace.
Ain't that pretty? Not the luckiest. Did you thank Uncle Arthur?
No need. We had a good time.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just met some folk. I better go speak with Dutch.
Okay.
Hey, you did real fine, kid.
Thanks.
We got a problem.
What?
I just met some guys out near the river. A fella named, Milton, and, I don't remember the other fella's name. Ross. Milton and Ross.
And
they are employees of the Pinkerton Detective Agency. And they know about the train, and they know we're here.
Were you followed back here?
No, they know we're near here. And they want you, Dutch. They offered me my freedom in exchange, they did.
Why didn't you take it?
Very funny. Well, what do we do now?
I say we do nothing. Just yet. They're just trying to scare us into doing something stupid. We have turned a corner. We survived them mountains. We just need to stay calm.
Your offerings, Mr. Morgan.
I will. Fine, but make sure you get a good price for it.
Good job, Mr. Morgan.
Morning, Mr. Morgan.
No more desperate, Strauss.
It's in a desert nature.
Less desperate, then.
Good, Pearson.
Hosea.
Say, Morgan! Morgan, you got any hair pomade?
Okay, boy.
You're a dog barker. This is my dog.
At least it ain't your job.
Shut up, Arthur.
Yeah, your job's starting the fights. You ain't winning them.
We can scrap, Arthur. I'm just not good at homework.
I can see.
Besides, what do you care, Englishman? You've got no time for me. I tried to find you work, but then you're off cutting jobs with other folks, and your boy Sean doesn't get a look in.
Guess I don't want to get shot, that's all.
Yeah, you're a real fucking funny shit, Arthur Morgan, huh? Real fucking funny.
Calm down.
You better sleep with your eyes open.
Yeah, well, you're gonna sleep with your chest open if you ain't careful, boy.
I love you, Arthur Morgan. I love you. Come on, take a shot. Come on, take your best shot, please. Yeah?
Grow up.
And let me come on the raid with you.
Raid?
Don't be playing coy with me, son. It's unbecoming. That bloody train you and him has set up. What you're doing out here, you're going to need guns, you're going to need men.
Oh, that. So Marston told you? It ain't a big show. I need comms. If I take you, I might as well bring Micah along.
Now compare me to that oily turd again. You're a dead man.
Fair enough.
Anyway, Arthur, what's your problem with me? In fact, don't tell me. I already know. You are threatened by me.
Threatened by you?
Yeah, my youthful vigor. It intimidates you.
Does it?
It's a story as old as the hills. The changing of the guard, the fading of the light. You're toast, old man.
Okay. And what are you?
I'm the future, in all its glory.
Yeah, well, good luck. Good luck and shut up. I want to get some rest before nightfall. Wake up, you lazy sir.
What are you doing here, kid?
I'm coming, John. On the job.
I said you weren't coming.
Yeah, well, Arthur says I am, and it's his party, boy, so come on, let's go. Me and the big cheeses love it. Can't wait to slit some bastard's throat.
You sure about this?
No. Are we ready?
Yeah. Train's due through tonight.
All right, then. It's on. Charles?
I'm ready.
Gentlemen, let's go earn some money. Yep.
Hey, all the horses untethered?
Think so.
Good. They should follow on behind us.
You find a good spot, Wolfman?
Yeah. Follow the trail southwest. There's a spot that's remote, but should still give them enough time to spot the oil wagon.
If they see this block of the tracks, they'll stop soon enough.
Apparently, picks up a new team of guards at the state line, so shouldn't be too much in the way of guns to deal with.
See? This is what I mean. I disappear for a couple of weeks, and you cut me out of all the action.
Just the action that requires a break.
Ah, you're a funny fella, John Marston. And my folks, eh? You had your feet up the whole time, playing sick, and fondling that new scar like you're gonna buy a breakfast in the morning.
They're left here, towards Rhodes. You don't know what you're talking about.
Stay close on this. Wouldn't want you getting scratched by a squirrel or something. That could put you out of commission for the rest of the year.
Why do you have to speak so much? It's incessant.
Plus, I've still got some blood in me veins. You old bastards have forgotten how to live.
I blame you two for rescuing them.
Far too much trouble for what we got out of it.
Yeah, takes a whole army of bounty hunters to bring in Sean McGuire. And look at me now, in the gunner's seat. Back in business, boys. You know, my dad always used to say...
Not the dad, please.
Not this again.
Fine. Damn you three. Sulky, angry, scarface. A right barrel of laughs. So, we blocked the tracks with the wagon, then jumping. That's the plan.
Pretty much. Charles, you deal with the engineer.
Here's good. Stop the wagon over the tracks. Remember, these are innocent folks. We handle this right, nobody...
Mr. Marston, Mr. Smith, Mr. McGuire, come! Get over there. When she slows, order.
And you?
I'm gonna make sure she slows.
I'll do or die with you. I like it.
Get moving. Here she comes.
Make that quick and join us on there.
All right, get on that train. All yours, Captain. We'll go on ahead.